Welcome to Film Companion South, Govind Vasanta.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for agreeing to do this masterclass for us, because it's really precious for us and for our viewers when a creator agrees to share his creative process with us and take us a little more into the world of cinema than we usually get. So thank you for that. So today you said you would be explaining how you compose, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
The scores, background scores.
What would you like to begin with? Do you want to just talk about background scores in general?
I'll just explain the process. I mean, the idea of me doing a background score first. For me, I'm more interested in background scores as far as film is concerned. If you ask me, I'm more of a independent music kind of a guy, because, you know, film songs have this format. It's 4 minutes, 4.5 minutes. You'll have to stop the song. So it's pretty difficult for me. So I choose background score because it has a lot of potential. You can destroy the scene or make the scene alive and take it to another level. So what I do is when I do a scene, I'll just start with 96 Trisha's intro.
Okay.
What I usually do is I watch the entire movie. First, I usually do it in order, so you'll get a flow. But this particular scene, there will be a goosebumpy point in the scene. I mean, there is a critical point in each and every scene. There should be the major changeover of the music should happen. So maybe that's in the middle of the scene. So I'll start from there, then I'll fill the beginning and the end. That's okay. My way of doing it.
Okay.
Now this Trisha's entry scene. So we in the film, as you know, that we all know Janaki is going to come. There is no need for a emotional introduction for Janaki. We all know who Janaki is. So the thing is, I didn't have to build the emotion so much. Also the song was a pretty notable one before the movie also. So what I did is I didn't have to wait for the face to come on the screen. So I started from the shot where she's walking.
I'm just going to interrupt you a little there, because just before you play this for us, or say take us through your composition process, you said that when you see the movie in its entirety, that's when you start selecting, where in order. You watch the scenes in order of the flow of the film and then decide when. But do you start thinking about possibilities even when the script is narrated to you before the shooting?
Yes, that's how I say yes to the script.
Okay.
When I hear a story, I need to get inspired musically. I need to, know that, okay, there is some space for me to do. So when 96... he narrated me, I knew I could, play a lot with silence. That's a bless, actually. You know, you can't do silence in many movies.
Right.
So that's a major part. I love to do silence, and, you know, that makes a lot of sense to me, at least. So when I heard the story, I was waiting to score this climax scene.
Okay.
Not the intro part, actually. No, intro part wasn't, I wasn't even excited about the intro part. The two parts were, I was excited to do was the flashback and the climax scene.
Okay.
So, yeah, so that's how I do it. Then I'll just play this scene, intro scene, without the music, just the dialogue. Can you hear the effects?
Yeah.
It's very uninspiring to watch it. So yeah, that is the scene. So I'll just play with the piano. It's not the exact thing, but I'll give an idea how I do it. Ta ra 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 ta ra ra ta ra ta ra ra That's how the intro goes. It was easier for me because the song was a hit before the film. So I didn't have to establish this. Everybody knows that tune. And we have only used it 3 times in the movie, in the beginning of the movie, here and the flashback scene. So in this scene, the goosebump moment is the back shot. So it's usually the intro of a heroine is the face or the, you know, so I didn't have to wait for the face. It's actually the way the music ends, the face shown. It's just the opposite we have done in this. And usually I don't like to end the music abrupt if it's not necessary. So what I do is I'll just leave a tail after the main music if it's not necessary to end it abruptly. If here and the na na ta na na ta re ta ra ra. Sort of a fade out thing, right. So it won't, it'll just merge into the movie. So I don't want it to, you know, flourish a lot.
So when you first saw the film, when you first heard this from Prem Kumar, is this something you heard? Is this the very first thing that popped into your head, or did you have to do a few like trial themes and then land on this?
For this scene you're saying? It's actually, it's a story actually. This that piece I didn't even compose for the film.
Okay.
That is, even after all the songs, we recorded all the songs and we started the background score. And Andhadi was a song we were supposed to shoot as a promo song. Then we decided not to shoot it, just release as a jukebox. So Andhadi le mattum oru portion da andha kaadale kaadale. It's not even a single separate song, or it wasn't a part of the movie. When you watch the movie, there won't be any kaadale, nothing. So after that, I thought, I'll just make a bonus version just for my, you know, satisfaction. I made a bonus version, which is the kaadale now you hear. So adhil mattumda indha that we somehow, and the time la he gave me the teaser, 1 minute teaser video. So I just sent him with this clipping, I just sent him. Then he was like, okay, this is perfect for this teaser. That's just for the teaser, but we didn't expect this to, you know, go viral and all. After the release of the teaser, then we really had to release as the song.
Okay.
People were asking for the song. But the song is like 2:50 or 3 minutes or something. I didn't want to extend also, just because of the, you know, thing that's supposed to be a short song.
Right.
That's how this bit came in the film.
And the music that you had for the scene when Janaki enters, that was the prelude of the song?
That's a bit in the song, actually.
It's in the interlude.
Yeah, interlude, yeah.
Okay. So this almost did not exist, and you would have probably done a different theme for this
entry.
Okay. So now I'm going to ask you, if that theme was not there and the scene is presented to you now, can you just improvise and provide a theme?
Try.
Yeah.
People will kill me now.
So Trisha is coming out. She's getting into the venue of the reunion. We see her back and start.
I will improvise from the original bit.
Okay.
Na ra ne na ra ne
Lovely. It's, you know, I can almost imagine the scene. So when a theme becomes so popular because of a teaser or a thing like that, you're saying it kind of pressured you into you know, having it because it became so associated with the movie. Is that right?
But we didn't do anything extra.
Okay.
It wasn't the discussion. Then Premana was also very supportive to not to extend it. Because I didn't want to extend it, definitely, because people were like asking for the full version. This is the full version.
So why didn't you want to extend it? Because you just at the beginning of this conversation, you said a film song is usually four and a half minutes. And that's all. So why didn't you want
to? That's why it's not a film song. This is 3 minutes, 2 and 50, you know. It's more like, you know, this song, no?
Right.
The end of the climax, that's just 1 minute or something in the movie,
yeah,
I guess.
Yeah.
That wasn't in the jukebox, no? I don't think that was.
I think I saw it for the first time in the movie. Yeah.
Yeah, movie. Yeah. So yeah. That makes a lot of sense in the movie. Then they released it separately. So, Adumari, this is like a. And you know, that dreamy effect should only be 2-3 minutes. Adukapramona, it will get boring.
Okay.
At least to me.
Okay. Let's have another scene.
Yeah.
Which movie is this from?
Again, 96.
Okay.
Climax scene. I'm not going to play the exact thing, but almost the same mood, because I don't remember what I played. This is in the airport. They are looking into the runway, and the announcement came after that. I wanted this to be a not a conclusion, but I wanted this to mean something just other than a music, because first half there's this song called Yen. When he leaves, she sings this, I mean, she imagines this song.
Right.
So on the part already happened, and I've used that score a lot of in other places. And the song I have used the silence a lot, because that's how I composed that bit. I'll show you. There are a lot of silences between the notes. So now in the scene, she is leaving.
Again, to interrupt you, when you say there are a lot of silences in the notes, are you also thinking psychologically that there needs to be this space because of the yearning and the separation and all that kind of stuff?
Exactly. I wanted that to, because that silence gives the audience to, you know, panic, basically. That, you know, suffocation happens, and the breathing, you can hear the theater.
Right.
That is something working, you know, that works in psychologically also. So that's why I wanted a lot of silence. Even the background score, we have used a lot of silence in school portions, and he sits in the bench. I wanted to, the atmosphere effects were very important. And the you know, kuruvis and everything, wind, we have used a lot.
Yeah.
So I wanted that to be heard, because that's a very nostalgic element also. So exactly. We wanted that to connect. So this scene, I used that song order in instrumental version. Thank you. it was the last scene of the movie.
Okay. So
that will, you know, ring in, inside the people's mind also. So.
Yeah, both these points that you showed us, that is the Janu's entry and this climax scene, did Prem Kumar offer any inputs about, like, okay, no, actually, that note, that's going too high. I want it in a lower register, something like that.
Not in this scene, because I didn't even tell him this idea about using yen as a... because when sometimes you need to hear it to
okay.
understand what I'm saying. I'm not a very good communicator. So
you're doing fine. So
so I showed him as it is. I played him with the complete final music. I didn't even... showed him the rough version.
Okay.
The final version with flute and strings and everything. Then he was completely satisfied. But by that time, no, I know what he wants. He yeah. knows what I'm going to give. We were in that rapport. So
there was a wavelength match happening. So
yeah.
So just to take a small break from composing scores, when it came to composing the songs, how different is the process? Is it the same process or... are you working on a different plane? Because, you know, it's also got to be like, see, a score is heard with the film, whereas a song can also be heard independently, like on the radio or something like that. So it has to work even without the support of the visuals. Yes. Do you keep that in mind when you compose?
I have to keep that in mind. And I am still trying to figure out how this music, I mean, film songs works. Because when I compose, I individually for my band or anything, the intro alone will take 1.5-2 minutes.
Yeah.
And I want to elaborate the song. I want to establish the mood of the song, then the lyrics takes. But that's not the case with film music. You need a formula, and you can't break it.
Right.
And you have the hero, heroine. So age group has to match for the singers. So there are a lot of challenges, and it's not something I have to get inspired first from the situation, but it's not very easy to get inspired from a film situation. It's normally a love song, a dance number. Yeah. You can't get inspired from that. You need more. If you watch the film for a background score, you have an entire story before you and the people are acting. But when I compose, I have to watch some other film to get inspired, or I have to hear another songs. I usually try to get inspired from other songs. Shamelessly, I would agree.
Okay. So let's say for 96, yeah. What was the music that you listened to compose some of the songs?
That is the difference between 96 and other films, I believe, because all the other songs other than Kadale was 6.5-7 minutes.
Yeah.
Andadi is like 7+, I guess. Vasanthakalangal, there is a 1 minute long guitar intro. Most of the other songs. So I had my freedom in that another thing is I knew the story very long time back. I know Premana very well. So he told me, and I've heard this story at least 10 times before starting composing. So I know each and every characters.
Right.
That's another thing. And I didn't have to shift the genre. It's in the same plane, the entire film, background score and songs. So it was, 96 was very easy for me to compose.
Okay.
Other films, Seedakadi was very difficult. Like all Balajana's films, it's a very confusing. Confusion is major emotion. So I had to work a lot for Seedakadi.
Do you want to play something from that?
Yeah, I'll just play my most favorite scene from all the films I've done.
Okay. Yeah, and that's from Seedakadi?
Seedakadi, yeah.
Okay.
I'll just play it with the music and then I'll explain how I do it. I can't play it here.
Okay.
It's the scene where when the director comes to ask Raj to act in his movie. So the manager says, one more time, just watch the acting, then decide. Then they are waiting for the performance of Raj and he gave a mocha performance, then someone else performed very well that day. So then the wife and Aya's wife and daughter realized that this is Aya in front of us.
Now, kelvi pottadunda aanal nammudaiya dharma magaraja vo thannaiye ilandu adipadinda binbu adimaiku madaviyo.
So that's a very two emotions are there. One is they are waiting for which one is Aya. They're searching, and if they don't even know if he's bluffing, the manager. Then they realize, the woman realizes her husband is alive, and the daughter realizes her father is alive, and the audience has to realize it's something beyond us. So it should have a very, you know, magical realism kind of a stuff. So that was very difficult, I mean, challenging for me. And I absolutely loved that scene. So how I approached is, the first 50, 60 minutes of the film, what I have done is, after Aya dies, I try to maintain a human voice.
Yeah.
Like a cappella kind of, you know, breathing. Even one song I've done, Avan song, majorly I've done the breathing as the rhythm. Because it's psychologically, breathing is the, you know, living thing, no? I mean, on the living organic feel on the reconnaissance, I kept that. And we have done that a cappella throughout the background score. So, you know, you'll feel that something angelic or dark or, you know, something not human is happening over there. So I wanted to keep that. That's why I used the voices. Once she realizes, I mean, the major point is, my major focus is on the wife. She realizes, okay, this is Aya. And it's a very confusing thing. You should be emotional, but it's not sad. She's very happy, but it is sad. Kind of a, and very confusing stuff. So it was very challenging and very interesting to work. I kept this one pulse like a heartbeat throughout the score, like, so you'll not miss the rhythm. Even if he's speaking, something is going on around us. Like Devigam Solumla, and the Mari, I wanted to portray, because adhukapram the major events are going to happen. So this scene was the most important scene.
Thannaiye ilandu adipadinda binbu adimaiku madaviyo keelo patra thuravugalo yen adimaiye udaiyanadhu.
So again, did this decision to use the pulse, these kind of decisions, did they kind of form in your head when listening to the script or when you saw the film?
This happened when I started composing. There is a song called, I told you, Avan. When Balajana describes the song very well, he knows how to, you know, make you convince what happened. And then he gave me the idea of using a cappella as like a chorus, no, more like a chorus song. So I thought, instead of using a chorus, like a normal chorus, I thought we'll use only, mouth percussions and body percussions and stuff. There are like snaps and...
like a castanet kind of sound?
Yeah. All, everything was human elements. This was the rhythm, basic rhythm pulse. And this was the high shaker kind of this thing. And the bass was... That was the foundation of the song. Then that we applied in the background score.
Ah, lovely. Okay. You've also done a lot of work in Malayalam. Do you want to...
I started in Malayalam.
I'm assuming there is no difference in the way you approach scoring for Tamil film versus Malayalam film, right? Is it the same?
Same.
Okay. So Which film would you like to pick?
I would do a Nyan Steve Lopez. I only did the background score for the film, actually.
Right.
Rajiv Ravi, as you know, the director, he approached me because he wanted to have a violin theme.
Okay.
Of a song from the movie, which we did the back, I mean, me and Shahbaz Aman did the composing together. We helped him, you know, doing the backing and everything, arranging and composing. Sort of a jamming session, and did that song. When the background score came, Rajiv Ettan called me. Someone else also have done some, like 2-3 reels of the film. I did from the probably like 30th minute from the film till the end.
Okay.
So I would pick the climax of the movie. There should be this warning, no? This is a
spoiler warning.
Spoiler warning.
Okay.
The climax scene of the movie.
Okay. So those of you who haven't seen Nyan Steve Lopez by Rajiv Ravi, you may want to skip this part.
So this is this, as this name suggests, this film revolves around this boy. So this is the last scene. He calls his girlfriend and says, I want to see you and I love you. And then he starts his journey. Then someone else from that other, the guy he saves, comes and kills him. So what we did is, I did a contrast approach.
Okay.
Because that's the end of the movie. That's, this whole movie is about him and his love and everything. So what I did is, we approached in a romantic kind of an emotional way. I'll play that piece.
Okay.
So that is the end of the movie. This scene and this film was very important for me because I never expected someone to agree to this kind of a music in a Malayalam film.
Okay.
I had to win such a crucial moment of the movie. He's getting killed. This is the music playing there.
Yeah.
So Rajiv Ettan is such a grace to work with. Super, you know, cool and everything. He so this violin piece, I've never, usually we use violin as a, you know, very Malayalam movies, at least, very commercial, very cliche violin thing. Tan-tan-tan-tan-ting. And very, very cliched use of violin. So I wanted to break that. So this is a 4-minute piece. So we used this one-ish minute in the end of the movie. And I was very happy that, you know, this film, that changed my approach to, you know, you use the contrast music in a good manner. This was a class for me, actually.
So usually when you say cliches, you know, you'd usually get violin in a sentimental moment or in a, you know, some very deeply emotional moment, like, you know, that kind of stuff. Whereas you actually applied it to a very contrasting kind of a stretch.
Yeah.
So when you hear, when people tell you the story, when Rajiv tells you the story of this thing, like at that point,
He never tell you the story. I saw the film. A composing line also, he just told me the situation.
Okay.
He didn't tell me the exact story or anything. And he approached me for the background score, then he sent me the film.
Okay.
So I didn't hear the story. I watched the film entirely.
So it was like when you watch it, it was fresh.
It was fresh.
And okay.
The final cut.
Okay. Brilliant. Yeah. When you think of music, right, when you're watching a film unfold in front of you, let's say Nyan Steve Lopez, because you watch it like a finished movie, right? How does music form instead? Do you hear it like a violin?
I hear it like a piano, actually.
Okay.
I compose mostly using piano. I don't play piano, like, as in I don't know. I haven't learned any piano lessons. I don't know the chords. I don't know how to name it, or I don't know how to read the music. But I can play melody.
Okay.
So I think as a piano, this thing, every song, almost every song.
Okay. So the first thing that you hear inside your mind is a tune that is played on a piano.
Yeah.
Okay.
This piano actually.
Okay. So at what point does the decision to say comes where you say, I heard this in a piano, but I want to play this in a violin?
Violin is more like I used to sing the interludes. I don't even play the, because I play violin, I normally don't prefer violin bits in my songs. I'm more like if it's my song, I'm more like a flute kind of a person, flute, guitar, bass kind of a film songs. I mean, if it's independent song, it's another thing altogether.
Yeah.
So song interludes, I mostly compose through my singing. I just play the backing with my piano, but the melody I make as a humming version.
Okay.
Then I play it around, and I don't decide the instrument first. If the melody is good enough, then I choose the instrument which suits that melody.
So for this scene, which you just showed us,
The
melody you heard in the piano.
No, this is different because Rajivedan wanted a violin piece.
Oh, okay.
He asked me to do a violin piece.
Okay, so then let me rephrase that question. So you hear the general, you know, a theme or whatever in a piano form, and you're kind of fleshing it out using your piano, like you know, a thing. And then based on that, you say, oh, you know what, this will sound good in a violin. This will sound good on a guitar. Is that how it goes?
Yeah, mostly.
Okay.
This case, Rajivedan told me to, he wanted a violin solo.
Okay.
Out and out violin solo. So what I did is, there is this, I just made a, just one bar and I looped it.
Okay.
I remember I played twice and this is a one take piece. Composed in like 5-10 minutes max.
Okay.
Two takes, I sent him both the takes. So we used like first half from the first take, second half from the second take.
Okay. How do you prevent your basis as an independent musician from influencing this kind of music, which is, as you yourself said, it's a different kind of process because you can't jam, you can't, you know, do your own little solo. It has to fit, first of all, it has to fit certain parts which have already been cut. And second thing is, you know, like you said in that other example so memorably, you have to find places to breathe and all that kind of stuff. It's not pure 100% music everywhere. Did it take a lot of like rewiring of your brain to, you know, transform from Govind Vasantha, the stage performer, to Govind Vasantha, the composer?
Basically, the use of instrument I totally changed. That is one thing, because if in the music, I mean, independent music scene, I am more like a hardcore metal kind of music I prefer to hear or play. Then the piano comes. I never use piano in my independent music scene.
Okay.
Any of Thaikudam songs, it's very rare that I use a piano. It's mostly tang. That is the main thing. So once the piano comes, the mood changes, you know, the process changes. But I try to, there is a pattern which I try to maintain, even if it's independent and film music. I make I don't usually repeat the Pallavi. I don't prefer to repeat the Pallavi. I don't think other than Life of Ram, I don't think I have repeated anything. Life of Ram, like Karavindi Pirahe, we have repeated in the end. But if you take Andadi is like, we don't come back.
Yeah.
It flows. Iravingithivai song has two charanams. Both are different, but it's more like a one charanam. There are no interludes in between. I love to make it as a flow.
Okay.
I don't prefer to repeat the, that's a formula for a typical film song.
Yeah.
then Pallavi again and ends the song.
Yeah, and that happens also because it's like the Logic and Pop songs, you want the audience to kind of come back to something familiar so that before you start off on the next interlude or something, you're kind of bringing them back to a comfort zone and then pushing them out again.
Yeah,
you're saying you don't necessarily want that.
I don't think so, because at least I'm trying to break that, because I personally listen to a lot of instrumental music.
Okay.
There is no Pallavi, no Charanam in instrumental music.
Yeah.
So, but I remember everything. Maybe even in our background scores, Raja sir's background score, we remember the background score. We don't remember the words or, you know, but the same logic, I think people, maybe we, over the time, we will get used to that. But Anda, I mean, Life of Ram or Andadi was a surprise that it's a hit song. I mean, I never imagined Andadi will ever be a hit song. It doesn't have any formula or any repeating thing other than that tune, yeah. But different lyrics.
Yeah.
But no lyrics are like repeating. It's everything is different.
Yeah.
So I think it's quite possible.
Fantastic. Thank you so much for taking us through that process. I know it's really difficult to talk about music. So thank you so much for trying.
I do the best.
Yeah. Thank you so much, Govind. That was a wonderful masterclass.
Thank you.